want a wide demographic of people, which is really cool, because now that I'm in the community, it's crazy to see how many people from all over the world are in it, and there's only 24 of us. But I'm sure we'll talk about that later. So
it's worldwide, not just Caribbean? Oh,
yeah, no, it's not Caribbean. It's pretty much every continent. It's unbelievable to see the work people are doing in other countries. So I filled out all the applications, did all the essays, wrote it all, applied for the grant, outlined exactly what I wanted to do with the money. I pitched a new campaign. So that was my thing. So I told them about Protect Our Future and what I had done in the past and all of it. And then I pitched what I want to do in the future, because I think that's what they're really focused on, is what you want to do going forward. So I pitched it around mangrove conservation. And it's something that I would have talked about before. It was this premise that we named, like, Mending Our Mangroves. And what we had wanted to do is promote mangrove sustainability. We want to kind of tackle that overarching Caribbean and global issue of overdevelopment in regards to mangroves. And there's a lot of branches we want to take it. We haven't fully outlined all the details because it's such a big project, but that's the exciting thing, is now that we have the resources and we have the help with Nat Geo, we can do almost whatever we want to with it, right? So kind of the sky's the limit for this now, which is super exciting, especially for the rest of the kids in Protect Our Future, because we have a wide range. We have now Protect Our Future juniors at CIS, so it's kids in elementary and middle school, because Protect Our Future used to be just a high school thing. It was just honestly for seniors that kind of really were invested, but now it's the younger kids. So to have them think of these crazy creative ideas that they really want to pursue and be able to give them the funding that they need and the resources, and have that big company like National Geographic push this media out, is going to be an unbelievable experience. What really struck me that I didn't know about the program, which I find amazing now, is the diverse range of campaigns and organizations that people have. I thought I was going to get in there and everybody was going to be really focused on reefs and mangroves. But I got in there, there was people from Africa, the Middle East, South America, all over Europe, every place that you could think of, and they were doing such impactful work. Like, there was a girl who focused on gray water, and she spent 4 years by herself and with other organizations just conducting scientific studies before she even started her campaign. So just to see the fact that everybody shares such a dedication towards their projects but have tackled it in such a unique manner was both inspiring but also allowed me to understand that with this community I'm going to be able to think so differently than I have before, because now I'm brought into something in which we all communicate on the daily. And we can pitch ideas off of each other to see what's going to work where, what's worked in the past for other people on certain topics. We can also press each other's media and campaigns forward. And then that overarching on top of everything is just that yellow rectangle, Nat Geo, who is kind of the big brother to all of this. They see what we're doing, we help each other, and they can help whenever needed. They can provide us with resources. Like, if we're doing things that require cameras, they have this big application form where you can request any sort of camera equipment you want. Right? So they're providing an outlet for us to be successful. And then with the content that we produce, we send it to them. If it's high quality, it's really well, and they're really proud of it, they'll then put it on their platforms, which will give us this huge environmental audience that you can't get to unless you have a company like Nat Geo helping you. And now we have close connections with really well-known organizations. I've mentioned Plastic Free Cayman is a big one locally. Captain Planet Foundation, the National Trust locally. What else do we have? Ocean Heroes Boot Camp. And now with National Geographic again, we are creating a reputation and a reputability where we've gone from a group of kids in a classroom at school, kind of with banners protesting for something, to more of an organization who is pushing for positive change.